Hi there, and welcome to Combin Growth demo application. First of all, I want to thank you for your interest in our service, and I hope that after watching this video, you will join our B Combin users family. My name is Anne, and I'm a marketing manager on Combin team, and today I'll be your guide and I'm going to show you all major Combin features in action. You will see everything on your screens, and I'll also comment on every feature you are going to see. Do not worry, if something is not clear or you need some more explanations or details on some issue, just ask me in comments below the video area. I'm sure to reply to all of them. So, without any further ado, let's get down to the presentation, Combin Growth application demo. Welcome! The picture you see on your screens now is the first thing you see when the application is launched. At the upper left, there are five tabs such as File, Account, Subscription, Tools, and Help. There is no need to speak much of these tabs, everything is easy. On the left-hand side, you can also see five tabs – Profile, Users, Search, Tasks, and Stats. These are the tabs you will work with the most. So, let's talk about each of them in detail. The first tab is Profile. Here you can see the number of your publications, number of followings and followers, followers-followings ratio, and engagement rate of your account. I'll speak more about engagement rate and followers-followings ratio in a separate webinar that I host every 2 weeks on Wednesdays, especially for newcomers. Also, here on the Profile tab, you can see the number of likes and comments under each of your posts. At the upper right-hand corner, you'll then be able to sort your posts by date, likes, comments, and virality in descending and ascending order. This helps you see what publications drive most engagement. Then, here comes Search tab, but we will skip it for a while and go to Users tab. So, Users tab. Here you can see all the users you are somehow connected to. Your followers, followings, unfollowed users, blacklisted, safe-listed people, and so on. About blacklisted and safe-listed users, it is not the people that you blocked on your Instagram, it is people that you blocked or safe-listed through Combin. If you want some more details on what that means, please ask me in the comments and I'll answer you as soon as possible. You can also see here people who do not follow you back, and you can unfollow them just in one click. If you click on the filter icon, again, you will see a number of filters. Here, you can specify the number of followers, followings for some particular list of users, apply a gender and language filter, and much more. Soon, there will be a new version release where you will have a possibility to create your own list of users, for example, close friends, favorite clients, favorite customers, and so on. Now, let's move on to Tasks tab. Tasks tab show you how tasks that you've set are progressing, how much is done already, and how much is left to do. Here you can pause the task or end it or delete it. And Stats tab or Statistics tab. Statistics is located at a separate menu tab. Here two sections are displayed. Various graphics in both sections are given to track the audience growth and user activity flow at different time periods. The top section displays four buttons. Clicking on them, you may learn a specific number of likes, comments, and follows that were left or gained. The time period for which the information is displayed can be changed in the upper right corner of the tab. The bottom section shows action types and counts performed by user via Combin. Sounds great, doesn't it? Now, analyzing these numbers, you can make sure that your marketing strategy is working great and Combin is a great contributor to promoting your Instagram page. This functionality, I mean statistics, is exclusively available on Combin's personal and business versions. Now, let's come back to the most important tab in Combin application, Search tab. Combin action algorithm is based on searches, so there are search by posts, or we also call it search by hashtags, and search by users. First, let's have a look at search by posts. To find hashtags related to your interest, product, or business, click Search in the left pane. Then, click Add Search button. Enter the hashtag you want to search for. Think of the hashtags your target audience might use and enter it. Let it be small business, for example. A list of suggested related hashtags will then be displayed below the hashtags box, so you can select your original hashtag or another one on the list. In case you want to create a multiple hashtag search, click the plus icon located to the right from the hashtag field. A new hashtag field will appear below the default one, and each time you fill a newly created search field, the option to add another hashtag appears. And here, I want to give you a small tip. If you are at a loss for what hashtag you should search by, think of words that describe and represent your business, occupation, and account content, as well as keywords your potential client is likely to use. Specialized sites and services such as display purposes provide many relevant options to choose from. Then, you can also specify location. If you want to specify a location to search in, use the place box. You can type the name of the place you want to search within manually, or you can change the location radius by clicking the map icon to the right of the place box. Also, you can specify when the posts were posted, so it's any time, last 2 weeks, last week, last day, but remember that the more you limit the time period, the less results will be found. And the last section is the maximum number of posts that will be shown in the results. It's up to 1,000. We also have likes, comments, count section. When you specify this setting, for example, you set the number of likes on 20 and comments on 15, the application then will only show you posts with the number of likes more than 20 and the number of comments 15. It's a very useful setting if you want to work with live accounts only. Also, in both search by posts and search by users, there is such a feature as advanced filters and analysis. If you enable this feature, you will see more filters available. You can set gender, language filters here, number of followers, followings of the accounts that are going to be found, and also you can see here author must be active last week feature. I recommend you to enable it every time because this is kind of guarantee to exclude bots and inauthentic accounts from search results. After all of the settings are done, click Find. And, in a while, enjoy the results. Now, let's come back a little bit. When searching by posts, it is not necessary to enter hashtag at all. You can search only by location. Just enter the location you'd like to search within, and that's all. Search by location is especially great for local-based businesses that would like to get customers within particular region, city, area, etc. So click Find, and again, enjoy the results. When all the results can be seen, you can also apply some filters here. In order to see a list of filter options suggested, click on a filter symbol in the upper right corner of the application. They are the same for both searches, by hashtags and by users. You can filter out private and public accounts. It is also able to filter posts you have already commented and liked, so in order not to seem too importunate. You can also hide posts of your following and followers. You can apply gender, language, following, followers, likes, comments count if you forgot to do this at the beginning of your search. Sorting options such as sorting by virality, engagement rate, and followers followings ratio are also here for you to apply. Filtering and sorting help you filter out those that are inappropriate for your goals. So, as soon as you found the audience needed and sorted the relevant results out of the list, it's time for interaction. But in order to get love for your page or your brand on Instagram, you firstly need to spread some love yourself. Posts that come up in your searches are easy to like or comment on, and users are easy to follow. You can interact with all people at once. For this, just choose Select All option, or you can select only some of them which you find the most appropriate for your goals. The task then will be added to the task queue, and you can see it's progressing in the task tab. But here, in this section, in the section of interaction, I would like to draw your attention to Combin commenting feature. I'm sure you know that some Instagram tools post generic remarks to thousands of posts at once, inadvertently marking your account as spam, and I'm sure you have seen some of these comments. But Combin allows you to write multiple custom comments that will be applied randomly across all the posts you've chosen. It is not suspicious and there are no risks for being banned, so just click the comment icon and write as many templates as you wish. You can also use the templates that our team already prepared for you. As soon as you are done with the settings, new tasks will be added and will be in progress. Comments will be posted automatically with Instagram rate limits in mind. This kind of interaction gets you noticed by like-minded and interested people who will engage with your profile in return in case they like your content. This approach provides steady audience growth that stays for good. And Combin is a surefire way of gaining you and, what is more important, engaged followers. Now, let's speak about search by users. This type of search allows you to find followers, followings, commenters, likers of some particular Instagram account, and also search by bio. In order to perform search by users, again, go to Search tab and click Add New Search. After that, choose Users. Then, we fill in the account. I typed Social Looks UK, so let's imagine that I'm a marketing agency, so the audience of this account, the audience of my competitor's account, is 100% interested in what I offer. Again, here you can specify all the settings that we just talked about in search by hashtags. You can select a different search limit if you want, and then enable Advanced Search and Analysis feature, specify all the filters needed, and then click Find. The results of your newly added search are displayed and the search is saved in your list of searches. Again, you can now start interacting with the users that you just found by means of liking, commenting, or following them. All the filters and sorting options to the results found are also available. Actually, these were all the main features I wanted to tell you about. One more important note, and I'll head over to pricing. Combin Growth works directly from your computer, which means that searches and tasks can be only published from a turned-on computer with a stable internet connection. That means that when your computer is turned off or is in a sleep mode, Combin does not work. So please remember that. And now, pricing and plans. Combin Growth has three plans: Starter, Personal, and Business One. Starter plan is permanently free. The only one limitation here is in-app action limits: 50 search results for post, 25 search results for users, and 100 daily action limits. And, as mentioned earlier, no statistics tab. Personal plan has no limitations, plus all the functionality included, but here you can manage only one Instagram account. If we talk about business plan, here all the functionality is included and you can manage up to 15 Instagram accounts from one computer and from one license. Thank you for watching this video, guys! If you have any questions considering Combin Growth or its features, please feel free to ask me in comments. I will reply them as soon as possible. Thank you and hope to see you among Combin Growth users. Goodbye!